Hi, my name is Farhan Riaz Ahmed. I'm studying in accounting and finance in my third year, and I'm running for the position of VP Student Activities.
You say that you want students to tell you what their priorities are.
Yeah.
But not all students have the same priorities. So given that the term of office only lasts 1 year, how are you going to set a realistic workable agenda for yourself as VP Activities?
So I was thinking of having group sessions. So most of the societies, for example, you take Adam Smith, you have Economic Society, you have Business School Society. So there are different societies which have basically the same agendas, but then it's just there are two different societies. So if you have group sessions with societies like those, so you have a group session with people from business school who have almost the same agenda, but not all the same aims. So once I get the aims from them, I can implement them, work upon them and help them achieve their goals.
So, but as you say, not everybody has the same aims. So how are you going to marshal all these different interests, all these different aims, and how are you going to create a workable agenda that you can realistically deliver within a year, given that all of the sabbatical officers have a huge daily workload?
Right. So I can have a leader from each society, for example, the president. I can work individually with them. Although they have different aims, but then if you start working during the freshers week onwards, I guess you can achieve their aims. Obviously you can't achieve all of their aims, but yeah, most of the aims which have the most priority, you can set those straight and work upon them.
You've been an SRC freshers helper,
yeah,
but you've never been on council. So how can you reassure students who think that you lack experience when it comes to how the SRC works and how the university works?
Right. So I have been in my first year, I have been the class representative. So I have had meetings with the staff and I've been in training with the SRC during that time. And then during the freshers helper week, I have seen people how they work. So I have a basic knowledge of organizing the events and whom to communicate when I need help with certain events, I'm having a difficulty with a session I'm not able to go to or do any media support. So I know whom to contact. So that is something which would help me.
You say that you want the three other student bodies and the SRC to cooperate effectively, but ultimately they are independent organizations.
Yeah.
They've got their own problems, their own priorities. Yeah. How are you going to go about ensuring that there is effective cooperation when it comes to things like organising events, promotion and social media strategy?
Okay, so for example, Freshers Week, all of the student bodies have their own events, but then I would like to, during the planning of Freshers Week, all of them come together and we communicate this. We have to remove the barrier between the societies, GU is better than QMU, so we need to get rid of that. And for example, with the grad week also, if you communicate with GUSA and you organize events such as, for example, color runs or climbing expeditions, so you're actually communicating with each of them rather than being your own individual student bodies. That will enhance your cross-campus connections and improve communication.
There's some members of the unions
quite
the inter-union rivalry. So if some people actually think that's quite a good thing because it creates some diversity on campus, it creates a kind of friendly rivalry, then why is that a problem? Why should the VP Activities be intervening to outlaw that, to make that a thing?
There's
past?
No problem as such. It's just some of the events, for example, if you take, it's easy to organize. For example, as I mentioned, for RAG week, if you have color runs, SRC might not have that budget or they may not be able to organize the whole event by themselves. So if you combine all the four societies, you have more students getting involved, you have more societies getting involved in those events, and you have more resources.
But all of these student bodies are ultimately kind of competing against each other for members, for business, for that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So what happens if they just say, no, we don't really want to cooperate to the level that you envisage, when really they are sort of competing against each other in a kind of indirect, informal way?
What do you mean? Can you explain the question?
Well, just what happens if the different student bodies don't subscribe to your vision for cooperation? What if they say, we want to do our own thing, we want to get things to continue the way they are? Well, how are you going to respond to that as a VP?
But then you can't be sticking to the same, like you need change. For example, like every year if you come to the Freshers Week, it's QMU having the same phone parties again, over and over again. So if you have like all the four unions coming together, you can brainstorm for more events. You have diverse events, like...
What if they like having the same phone parties over and over again? What happens if that's what they think their members want and that's what they continue to do? Why does the VP activities need to intervene in that?
I just think that if, for example, their events, like phone parties as such, most of the students go for it, but then there's certain students, for example, people who don't drink, they don't get involved with those activities. So, okay, they might not like me intervening with them, but then at certain point you have to, because there are other group of students who actually don't go to those events. You have to create events for all the students, not just a group of students who are drinking. There are other students who don't drink. They need events for them.
You say that you want to get funds for student media through sponsorship. Mm-hmm. Not all student media outlets are going to be happy with that. Indeed, some of them don't even run adverts.
Right.
Is this policy realistic and workable, given that student media is editorially independent of the SRC, and there is no guarantee that editors, controllers, managers will go along with this?
According to the previous meetings with the previous candidates, I saw that they're highly involved with the material which is published by the student media. So I was thinking, for example, funds in the sense is the student media requires more instruments, for example, mics or stuff like that, but do they have enough funds for that? So I want to get enough funds for the student media so that they can develop and have more resources available.
But in your manifesto, you talk specifically about sponsorship.
Yes.
And some of the student media outlets, which are totally editorially independent, the SRC does not intervene with operational decisions, editorial decisions. If student media outlets are not happy with the idea of sponsorship, sponsorship from private businesses, independent of the university and the SRC, how are you going to make them go along with this if they simply don't want to?
It's basically for the benefit of the student media. So as long as they're happy with it, I'm fine to go along and help them to get the sponsorship.
But what if they're not happy with it? Are you saying that even though this is in your manifesto, it's entirely up to the different editors, managers, controllers of student media?
Yeah, because they are independent, so obviously they'll make their own decisions. But then if they require some more resources, I can help them get those for sponsorship.
So this isn't a serious manifesto commitment, and if it's entirely up to these different bodies,
it is a serious commitment, but if they don't want to, then I can't convince them if they want to be independent.
Which they are.
They are independent.
I'm saying if it's in your manifesto that you want these different student media bodies to get sponsorship, then how are you going to compel them to do that if they're editorially independent and some of them might not be interested in that?
Basically, sponsorships for example, if you take Rag Week, so suppose I want to get a piece of information in Guardian, so I can I can buy that cover for advertising Rag Week or something.
But advertising is different from sponsorship.
Right.
But even advertising, not all of student media has advertising. Gus don't have advertising, Sub-City don't have advertising on their on-air broadcasts. Mm. So even though you think these things might be to the benefit of these student media outlets, how are you going to compel them to do it? How can you make good on this manifesto commitment?
I can have a meeting with them and a group session where I can ask them the areas which they need improvement and are they willing to collaborate with the SRC to get sponsorships.
What if the answer is no?
If the answer is no, I can't help them with that because they want to be independent.
Engagement with home students, who make up 40% of the student body here, has been a priority for the current VP activities. How do you intend to ensure that the SRC continues to improve engagement with home students?
For example, for home students, there you have the GUSA, they have memberships for students living in the halls. So if they could extend those memberships for free memberships for students who live at home. So I would like to do that. Second thing is during Freshers Week, you have free bus service from the campus to back to the halls. So I would encourage them to have like free bus service even for the students who don't live in the halls and are like living at home.
Thank you very much.